Hello guys and welcome to another project of mine. This is Super Mario Kart. No, this is Mario Kart 64. And it got hacked, as you can see. Because this version is called Mario Kart 64 Amped Up. And it's made by Litronom. You know, Mario Kart modern community was always really nice, or was always really, really cool, especially with Mario Kart Wii, Custom Track Grand Prix Revolution. Genius! Never got to play it myself, sadly, because I couldn't modify my Wii U and I didn't have a Wii anymore, so F. But we can play this. Mario Kart 64 hacks aren't that old, to be honest. Like 1 or 2 years. I don't know how old Amped Up is now, but this is version 2.1. Litronom already said in the Discord that next version 3.0 will have new tracks, and I will play them, of course. I will play all the new tracks if they come out. But for this, we have 3 cups with 4 tracks each, and I will show you everything. And yeah, let's get right into it. We have, first of all, different options. We have game options right here. We can turn on N64 coins. They serve... it spawns like these, as you can see, these purple 64 coins on the tracks. And if you collect all of them, they're in pretty interesting spots. Not always on the racetrack. I found most of them actually off track. But when you collect all of them on one track, you get a very special item, I would say, or like a very special effect. I don't know if I probably will show that, but by then I will be dead last. You can have a mirror mode. First time in Mario Kart 64 that you can have mirror modes. Because first game with mirror mode is actually... Double Dash, I think. Double Dash is the first Mario Kart with mirror mode, if I'm not wrong. But yeah, with the Mario Kart 64 community, with Amped Up, with Ultra Kart 64, which has a very similar options menu, you can have mirror mode. You can have GP always advance on or off, so in Grand Prix that you always have the next track or not. There's an all-cup mode, which is really cool. You can set different multiplayer options, and you can actually have all racers behave the same. Or like the default, which is, I don't know, Toad and Yoshi are one of the fastest because they're light class, and Donkey Kong is really heavy, and you know? And you can, of course, like this mod. I do love this mod, but I don't know what this changes, so I always kept it off. Next thing we can have is mod options. We can have a practice mode, a flycam, an input display, actually, which is really nice, and details, like time details for something. And there are options for rendering. We can even have widescreen, but... I know, I never turned that on. I don't know if it changes in-game or not, we will see. We can have a multiplayer screen split, you can set it on horizontal or vertical. There's a draw distance, I will do that extended, because on default the item boxes spawn in like right in front of you. So when you use this mod, always put draw distance on extended. These options don't get saved, as far as I know, but yeah. We can have a game tempo by console emulator. I didn't mess around with that option, to be honest. Maybe do that off cam, but I see. As I do with widescreen. So, let's just press A and get started. Of course, I'm alone, so we play a one-player game. Mario Grand Prix. And I thought of playing 150cc. But this game is already pretty unfair on 100cc, so I'm sorry, I'm usually the 150 guy, but we will play on 100 today. So this is just a normal Mario Kart 64 menu, just with a different music. And of course, this channel is called XYoshiLP. I'm Yoshi, so we will obviously use Yoshi. And yeah, let's get started with the Mushroom Cup. We have Ancient Lake, GameCube, Nintendo, Mario Circuit. So from Double Dash, we have a course called Tsumuri Beach, which is, I think, a track from the arcade series, the Mario Kart Arcade GP series. And Ancient Lake is, by the way, from Diddy Kong Racing. And we have a fully new course called Calamari Canyon, and I love that course. It's a very, very good course. You can see I already played this, and I got gold. Yeah. So to my knowledge, there's no way to turn off Total Time. But I see about that one. So I already got the boost. Oh, I have the coins on. Okay. So yeah, of course on the first course, the N64 coins are mostly on the track. Oh, we already got a banana bunch. This is the first Mario Kart 64 hack I've seen, which features... Oops. I actually turned off the music, I'm sorry. Which features custom music. Yeah, with an L button press, you can lower the volume of the music. I wanted to press this button. Wow, Peach drove into my banana bunch. There we go. Let's try and collect all these coins. I think there's... Okay, there's one right there. But yeah. As I said, this is the first 64 ROM hack, Mario Kart 64 ROM hack I've played with custom music, and it's just so nice with custom music. As it even, the instruments even fit very nicely. Okay, Peach is dead. So we've got 7 from, I think, 10. Or is it 8? No, it's 8. Okay, yeah, so when you get all 8 coins per track, you get a star. And a slight speed boost, even. Which is really, really cool. It's really nice that... it's almost like... You know, it feels like when Case programs something completely new, like completely new power-ups or something, in Super Mario 64. Like we already saw in the last few parts of Super Mario 64 Last Impact. By the way, you should know that, you should watch that project. It's pretty fun, and sometimes skill, sometimes rage, really nice. But yeah, these purple N64 coins feel just like that, because it's a feature that was never in this game. And it's really cool to have, it's really, really cool to have. So next up, we have... This is actually the Titus ride, Mario's Raceway, from Double Dash. And I like how the instruments even fit with this. There you can see there was a... here's another N64 coin off track. But yeah. I'm not gonna lie. Even though Ultra Card has more... I will play that too. Yeah, but this first. Even though Ultra Card has more tracks and so... It just doesn't have the charm of this game, I think, because it doesn't have custom music. But I think that will come too soon enough. But that's why I just like this. I just like amped up a little more than Ultra Card. I'm sorry. But yeah, Litronome, very good job. I can say this in the first part. And yeah. So I like how even the Goombas are a 3D model. It's sad there are no piranha plants that eat you, but you can't have everything. Maybe they can change it someday, but yeah. It's actually funny playing a GameCube track on the N64, because this is like a re-demake or something. Don't get me wrong, it looks very fantastic, it looks very nice. There we go. I mean, even the you win music, or like the placement music, and this points research screen music is... Even that is custom. And I have to say, I like this music, which is playing right now, far better than the original one. I don't know if it comes from a different game, or if someone even made this music up. But I just like it. It feels really like Mario Kart. So this is the beach track from the arcade series. If I'm correct, I can't remember. Oh, I didn't get the Turbo Star. We got a golden mushroom in like, what, second, third? Which means we can just do this. Ah yeah, even mushroom against the wall, why not? And the AI is still as fast as we are. I mean, this game is pretty known for its rubber banding. Oh no. Oh, wait, did the shell actually go backwards? I think so. There's actually... it is possible to save yourself from spinning out from a banana. Oh my god, I got a golden mushroom. In this game, but it's extremely hard. Go Yoshi, boost across this. And you shouldn't drift too much, or like, drifting is very, very risky in this game. You don't lose as much speed while turning in, but for that you don't get a speed boost, and you can spin out if you do it wrong. So, but it's normal, it's just Mario Kart 64 physics. So just saying, if you never played Mario Kart 64 and you want to play a ROM hack like this, it doesn't play like other, like the modern Mario Karts, of course. It plays a lot like the first games, Super Mario Kart, and like Super Mario Kart Super Circuit, which is the third Mario Kart. No, get away from me! Yeah, so we shot Peach, now Toad the second. He's closing up really fast. Oh my god. That was actually like a little jump scare. No. No. Yeah, see, this is like... Oh my god, I had such luck with that banana. If that banana wouldn't have been there, I would have lost. Like, not lost, but... I don't like getting second place against AI. Yes, on to the last track we go already, which was Calamari Canyon. Based on Calamari Desert from this game, even with the train. And even the music is a remix of Calamari Desert, which sounds really good. Yeah, I really like this canyon. And there's even like a train... a train whistle, choo choo, in the song. It's such a nice song. It's just such a nice track, and it's a pretty long track too. I mean, what you expect of a canyon. And we have two paths, so the AI will always drive on the lower path. I'll show you the lower one first. So we got a few piranha plants. We got a big gap to fall down, or two actually, in this tunnel. Wow. But yeah, I like how the song suddenly represents a train. But yeah, you can see these tracks look way better than like normal Mario Kart 64 tracks. It's just the emulator can have a little bit more memory space or a little bit more RAM. I wanted to jump and I pressed the wrong button. Problem, of course, on this track is if you fall, you fall for a long time till Akito picks you up again. Okay, upper route it is this time. And of course that's wanted like that. It's not like an error or something, like a coding error or something. It's supposed to be like that. Oh, almost spun out there. But yeah, when you do spin or almost spin out, you lose a lot of speed when drifting. Luigi just drove into it. Oh, we got a star in second place. Yeah, that's normal. Let's go, let's catch Toad. Here it is already. By the way, I always thought, oh my god, I missed the item box, I'm so stupid. I always thought that Mario Kart DS was the first one to have Slipstream, but it's wrong, actually. I figured it... How did I miss those and drive into the banana? I figured that only out in this mod, to be honest, that oh, Mario's stuck here. But yeah, I figured this out in this mod that there's Slipstream in this game, actually, in Mario Kart 64. No, we're so close to the end. And I like the way how the camera zooms out. Oh, of course he steals my item. Thing is, I don't know what he has as an item, so... Mario, can you like... Yes, boost me, thank you! Thank you! Let's go, Yoshi, let's go! Yes! So we got first place every race! Full points! Nice! Yeah, there we go. That was the Mushroom Cup from Amped Up. I just love this hack. I'm so excited for the next tracks in next update. Because I don't know what tracks there are. Really. Even the results music is everything's changed, and I. But it sounds so good still. There's so there are many ROM hacks, like not from this game, but Mario 64, for example, where the instruments just don't sound right for the song. But in this game, everything's just perfect, you know. Okay, not really fully perfect. But it's just so good. And when I'm telling you this in the first part, you know what we are up to. So yeah, there we go. This is our gold trophy in the Mushroom Cup. Woo! Yeah, and that's it. This was the first cup from Mario Kart 64 Amped Up. I will see you in the second part. See you then, bye bye.